I obviously rise in support of Senate Bill 3, I have found myself very moved by the supporters in the room today, by the breadth of the support that we've seen. From Philadelphia County to Allegheny County to the very powerful words from my colleague from Armstrong County. And I suppose I am equally disturbed by a lot of what I'm hearing from the opposition. Made up statistics about the deaths that medical marijuana has not caused, and co-opting tragedies and accidents that had nothing to do with medical marijuana to somehow justify not giving medicine to kids. I want to make sure, as many of my colleagues have done before, that I recognize the families, many of whom are here today, that have been the driving force behind this issue. There's no question that their unwavering commitment, their dedication, in the face of almost insurmountable odds, in the face of our gridlock, are certainly inspirational. And I know that we, the supporters of this legislation, along with the 225,000 Pennsylvanians who will ultimately benefit from his passing, are extremely thankful. I imagine you're sick and tired of our words, sick and tired of the back and forth. Many of you are quite literally sick and tired, and you want us to pass this legislation. Mr. Speaker, Republican or Democrat, progressive or conservative, I believe that every single member of the General Assembly is ultimately here because we strive to do one fundamental thing: to help our constituents and to help the people of Pennsylvania. And though our perspectives may differ on how to accomplish that mutual goal, we derive our motivations from this shared endeavor, no question. There are people in our communities, there are people in this room right here, right now, suffering from debilitating medical conditions. There are children with severe seizures. There are veterans scarred by war. There are those fighting HIV/AIDS and those who suffer daily in perpetual pain. There are those battling cancer through round after round of chemotherapy. We're not able to cure or to even treat every illness, but we are able to provide an opportunity for roughly 225,000 Pennsylvanians to improve the quality of their life. As legislators, we cannot deny patients and their families a chance to alleviate some, just some, of this immense suffering, a suffering that few of us can possibly understand, although many do. We cannot deny a family who has tried every option to treat its loved ones an attempt to find hope and solace in medical marijuana. Mr. Speaker, during this time of political turmoil, we have achieved something unusual. We've achieved bipartisan support for legislation that will stem the tide of the opioid epidemic in our Commonwealth. We've come together to address every issue within our power to aid communities ravaged by opioid addiction and abuse. We took the much-needed step to expand the use of medication to save the lives of overdose victims. We've established a prescription drug monitoring database to investigate how these dangerous drugs are flooding our streets. And we've implemented a Good Samaritan policy that helped pave the way to more overdose victims getting the emergency medical service they need. As a legislature, Mr. Speaker, we have recognized this problem time and time again, and though we have adamantly disagreed on many issues, we have always worked together to address this particular crisis. Today, we have the opportunity to make a major bipartisan step in the fight against the opioid epidemic. In states that have accessible and effective medical cannabis programs, opioid-related overdoses have fallen by nearly 25%, as we have heard time and time again today. Let's not be mistaken, Mr. Speaker. We are not trailblazers when it comes to this program. Nearly half the states in our nation have implemented medical marijuana programs. And while opponents offer the parade of horribles that would come from passing this bill, frankly, all of those of us in this room with common sense know that they are simply not true. We've been fortunate enough to be able to look to other states for evidence, and there has been no dramatic rise in crime, no substantial diversion to the black market, or any serious adverse effects. If we look at the data, if we actually, as a legislature, look at the data available to us, we'll see that since the first states passed medical marijuana nearly 20 years ago, we know that the fear and the opposition, however well-intentioned, have simply had no merit. There is no metric to measure the smile on a child's face when they can go a day without a seizure. A parent's joy when their child can laugh and play again. The pride a veteran feels when they can regain control of their life, or the hopeful relief of a patient in daily insufferable pain, like many of the people in this room. Despite our differences, despite our often opposing politics, this issue has gained such broad support in this body. And it's not because of the persuasive arguments. It's not because of the incredible statewide support or the recognition of a problem with a potential solution. The reason we're here today voting on this legislation is because there is not a member here that can look at those patients and those families and those children and not imagine what our lives and the lives of our loved ones would be like if they were similar. Few of us can imagine the frustration of being helpless when a person we love is suffering. And Mr. Speaker, we have the opportunity to help. We have the opportunity to help. It is for that reason and the fundamental shared reason which brought all of us to this chamber today that I'll be voting yes on SB3. And I strongly urge all of my colleagues to stop talking and to start acting and to support the people in the back of this room because they've supported us and they deserve our support. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.